Hey guys, welcome back to the Philadelphia Union podcast. I'm Zero, so let me make sure it's recording here. And I want to talk about the DC United game, of course, the big game tomorrow. But the DC United game, we won 3-1, which was a good result. It was a big test for us, a desperate DC United team. We managed to dominate large portions of the game and win 3-1 at home. But it's important because the game before that, you see here, Chicago. We were not good. We just completely underperformed. We were up a man for a lot of the game. We lost 2-0, and just Chicago kind of bunkered in and sat back after going down a man, which was understandable. But for us to not really create a lot of chances, it was just very disappointing to not get anything out of that game. But Jim Curtin made a couple changes to the lineup. He brought in a couple kids. He brought Aronson, first of all. He brought in Brendan Aronson back into the lineup, starting lineup, and he was phenomenal. His best game of his young career, scored a goal, assisted another against DC, and he was just brilliant at finding those little pockets of space like a number 10 should. Very excited to see if he can have games like that more often, But he shows the talent that he has. Another one, interesting one, he brought in Mark McKenzie, the young center back, another one of our homegrown players. In for Aurelien Collin, who was horrible against Chicago. McKenzie stepped in only second game of the season, and he was great. Very sound, very solid, didn't make any mistakes, was just very solid in there and helped us win that game. So hopefully he can, put together another performance like that against Atlanta coming up next tomorrow. Now, I don't know what happened to Austin Trusty and why he isn't playing anymore. I know he had some bad performances and was kind of benched, but maybe he picked up a knock or something. I don't know. He's not even on the 18 anymore, so I don't know what's going on. So maybe I'll have to read in more into that. I'm not sure what's going on with him. But McKenzie next to Jack Elliott seems to work right now. I assume Curtin's going to start them again together against Atlanta. We will be without our captain tomorrow and perhaps the biggest game of the season. Our captain's out because the referee gave a stupid yellow card to him against DC United. It was not a yellow card foul, but he gave it to him for his only foul of the game, really. And therefore, Bedoya is suspended on accumulation. And some players are going to step up. I'm not sure if he's going to start Aronson and Fabian, or maybe with Pico, or if he's going to bring in Cravall in there and have Montero go back up. Which is where he should be. I'm not sure what Curtin's going to do with the lineup. It'll all be revealed tomorrow. Big game against Atlanta, obviously. And then we have LAFC after that. This game against Pumas is just a friendly against a Mexican team, which is really cool. Good for fans of those teams to kind of see them. Because there is a bit of a week break here, I think, with an international break here. So just a chance to get the team to get a game in. And host a team that you're never really going to play too often. Anyways, you see here in the standings, Atlanta and us are tied, so it's a massive game. There's no words I can really say to see how big this is. We win this game, we go back on top for the moment. Atlanta has a game in hand on us, though NYC has two games in hand, and they're just a point behind us. They're actually the team that probably. We're most scared of right now, NYC, but we want to stay in the top three or four so we can host a playoff game. But tomorrow is going to be a big test for us, especially without our captain. Atlanta, NYC, these teams are way more talented than us, but we're still putting together such a great season for a club that doesn't really have great seasons under their belt. So this is all new to us, all new to me. It's exciting times that we have these big matches we can look forward to. Atlanta tomorrow. I can't wait. I'm gonna have a plan. I'm blasting on my TV. I'm gonna have some food and just get into every kick. Can't wait. Hopefully we'll have a good performance and go after them. Don't sit back. We're at home. We gotta go in their faces and get after them because they can be beat. They have 9 losses, Atlanta. We've actually lost less than they have. So they could be beat. We've scored more goals than them, so. They're going to be without one of their young stars, Ezequiel Barco, who's missing on suspension or injury, something like that. He's not going to be playing. So that's going to bode well for us, too. Maybe it'll bounce a little bit with Bedoya out for us. I'm just very excited to watch that game, and I just wanted to talk about what's been going on here. Worth noting also, we picked up the option for Trebilco for 2020, so he will be with us still. Good thing. Trebilco has been a revelation up top for us this season. He's our leading goal scorer. He's got 12 goals, 3 assists. He's been great. And he hasn't even, this is his only games he's played in MLS. I think he's played like 22 games or something. Has 12 goals in his career here this season. So he's been fantastic. Irreplaceable right now. Because Wooten's come in and he hasn't really done anything since coming. He started a game or two. He's come off the bench. He just doesn't really look comfortable out there, to be honest, Wooten. One chance he had against Chicago to put the ball away, he just slipped, missed the ball completely, and it was like, okay, like this guy is coming over from England, playing in, what is supposed to be better football, and he can't even stay on his own 2 feet. So I don't know. Wooten hasn't worked out yet. I still got hope for him. I just hope he's not another Jay Simpson that comes here and just lays an egg, basically. So Wooten needs to step up and score some goals for us because we're going to need them. Can't just rely. We have a collection of players that kind of score goals. Ilsinho, Pico, Chilbilco, Madunian, Fabian, Aronson. Just everybody steps up and scores. Montero, of course. So it's a collection. We're not relying on one guy, which is good. We don't have that one superstar that we can point to and be like, hey, get us, going. We're very much a team collective, which is nice. I like that sort of team. I don't like one superstar to kind of have to lean on. I guess that's going to do it here, guys. Talked about everything I think I really wanted to talk about for this episode. If you're a fan of MLS, fan of the Union, let me know, of course. I know not a lot of people watch these, which is fine. Still going to talk about them. But don't be afraid to leave me a comment or something if you happen to do watch this. And let me know what you think, what's going on here. I'd love to connect with more Union fans as always. That's the ultimate goal here. So I'll see you all in the next one. Till next time, zero is the number.